Welcome back to Gemology for Schmucks, everybody. Once again, I'm Peter Nelson, and I'm here to talk to you about some of the secrets of gemstones. So last week, we talked about how when light goes from the air into the gemstone, some gemstones will split light. And today, we're going to continue on that concept, but with a different effect that it gives us. So when light goes from one substance, like the air, into another substance, like the water, it will actually bend, right? If you've ever tried to grab a fish, you know it can be incredibly difficult, because where we see the fish is not where it physically is located. Why is that? Because when light goes from the air into the water, instead of going straight, it actually bends. It slows down a little bit because it's a more optically dense material. In order to grab that fish, you have to reach in, not to this location where we see the fish, but over here. Same thing happens in gemstones, except there's no fish. So another thing that can happen, yes, light is being bent, but in doubly refractive stones, so that stones with two rays of light, the distance between those two rays is called birefringence. Bi meaning two, and refringence. Refringence and refraction are very similar. So refraction is how much light is bent. So if it is doubly refractive or birefringent, more or less the same thing, then if it splits light widely enough, we might get a double image on the other side of the stone. When you're looking for doubling, you're looking at one spot on the facets on the other side of the stone. And if you see the same image mirrored, so there's two of them, then that is what we call doubling. If you see doubling, what do we know? Well, we know for sure that this stone is doubly refractive. So if somebody is coming, for example, and saying that, oh, this is a diamond, and it has doubling, then it can't possibly be a diamond, because diamonds do not split light. If it's not a diamond, it could be a number of other stones that are white that do split light. So it could be white zircon, for example. It could also be synthetic moissanite. Moissanite is typically not a natural stone. Ooh. Now, our human eyes have limits, and if the birefringence is too small, then you're probably not going to see the doubling effect, unless you're a cyborg. Some stones have a larger birefringence, something like zircon, for example. Now, all of these colors are zircon. We've got the blue zircon here, we've got some other reds, greens, yellows. There's also white zircon. There's plenty of different colors of zircon. And one of the interesting things about zircon is that the blue zircon has a very strong birefringence, which means it also has a strong doubling effect. You will also see a doubling effect in other stones with a large birefringence, something like this Turkish diaspor. So right here, as we look down into the stone, straight through the table, we can see doubling on the other side. Singly refractive stones like diamonds, garnets, or something like glass will not do this. Now, when you're looking for doubling, you have to be careful of one thing. As we said last week with pleochroism, there are certain angles in the stone that have what's called an optic axis. Sometimes we call it the C axis. And that is the angle, the part of the stone that does not split light. And that also happens in doubly refractive stones, stones that do split light. If you're looking for this doubling effect, you need to look at the stone from different angles, just like with pleochroism. Certain angles, if it has doubling, you will see it. Certain angles, even if it has doubling, you won't see it. So how do we check for doubling? You start out with your tweezers right here, and you will also need a loop, a 10 times triplet loop that we talked about in another episode. Check it out right here. The first thing that you're going to want to do is use a nice cloth, okay? Microfiber, or the cloths that you use to polish your glasses, or a personal gemological favorite, chamois.
This is not a sponsored video.
You're going to hold the stone typically in your left hand, your non-dominant hand, and your dominant hand is going to use the loop, just like we showed you before. Now, when you're looking for doubling in the gemstone, you can look straight through into the table, onto the other side, and look at the back facets. Depending on how the stone was cut, if the stone was cut and the C-axis is right here, then these facets down here at the culet, we're not going to see doubling. The next direction that you want to look is from these crown facets through to the other side of the pavilion. So that gives us more of an angle through the stone. If you don't see from the table side, you may see it from this direction. Now, once again, that's only if the stone has strong enough doubling for you to see. You have to have an idea of what stone you're looking for and whether or not its birefringence is large enough to show doubling. Okay, so quick review. Refraction is what happens when light goes from the air into a more optically dense material, whether it's water, whether it's crystals, whether it's whatever. When it hits that optically dense material, it bends, okay? Doubly refractive stones split light, and the angle between that split is called birefringence. The larger that birefringence, the higher chance we have something called doubling. And if there is doubling, we know that light is being split, and it's not a singly refractive stone. So a singly refractive stone only has one ray of light that's being bent. So you have to know about the nature of the stone that you're interested in buying. If you're looking for diamonds, if you're looking for white sapphires, if you're looking for white zircon, they're all going to have different birefringences. Some of them you will see a doubling effect. Diamonds, you will not see a doubling effect. So this is just one more piece of our toolkit that helps us to understand, is this stone what people say it is, or is it something else? And it's all down to the natural properties of that stone. So that's all I've got for today. Thank you for joining me on Gemology for Schmucks. Go out there, check out some more stones, broaden your mind, and appreciate the treasure of this earth. And I'll see you next time.